I'm not going to make any waves. Is that what you said?
Yeah, that's what I said, Sarge.
So why did I have to stand there with the captain from the 2-7 squad telling me how much he had to talk his detective out of going to the union with this?
Come on, Sarge. That guy was a schmuck.
He said you accosted him.
Hey.
Finally, somebody I could reason with.
Finally, someone who understands me.
Wow. Like this. I go away one day, come back all appreciated.
Yeah. Well, he's not playing well with others again.
Come on, Sarge. The Emmy just changed the manner of death to undetermined.
How'd you manage that?
I know people.
Are you up to speed on this?
Yeah, I read the file. He had a blunt force trauma to his head.
Right, which the Emmy now says may have been caused by someone hitting him.
And he also was in debt up to his ears.
That's right. And look at this picture, Sarge. And this photo was taken of the chair that Keenan used to allegedly hang himself. These footprints, Sarge, they don't belong to Keenan.
No one else in the scene followed up.
Exactly. That schmuck detective didn't even bother to follow
up. Okay, I get it. You made your case. Consider the investigation yours now.
Thank you.
But no fights.
Okay.
No tussles with the FDNY and no complaints from the ME's office. All right?
Yep.
And please, no threatening to put anyone through a wall. Capiche?
Capiche.
I know a couple of firefighters over at Keenan's engine company. I'm going to see if I can find out anything.
Give me a call. Let me know what you find, Jack. Thanks, Arch. I thought for sure you were going to tell me to drop the case.
Well, first of all, if I told you that, you'd do it anyway, right?
Probably.
And second of all, you're the best pain in the ass I have.
And we've seen your rap sheet.
Yeah, well, that was all in the past. Miles wasn't a mark. I did not change my name to start new scams. I did it to change my life.
You cozied up to a lonely kid and you tried to steal his college fund. And you know what? It's the way you hurt him that makes me sick.
Well, it wasn't me. And whoever did that to Miles better pray I don't find them first.
If you want us to believe you, you better give us something, Jack. Because right now, the only connection we see between you and Miles is you killing him.
Listen, all these entitled brats around here look at me like I'm dirt. Miles was different. We could talk. He lost his folks. I got kids my wife won't let me see. It was as simple as that.
Mrs. Schroeder, right?
Mr. Neary.
Like a soft night in Wicklow, isn't it?
I couldn't say. I'm from Kerry.
Ah, the lofty peak of Carinta Hill.
Did Mr. Thompson not speak with you today?
About what?
Your business here.
We'll be out of your hair by tomorrow. Most of this stuff is for the Celtic dinner. Listen, fellas, you gotta keep it down. People are trying to sleep here.
What say we pour you off a growler for St. Paddy's? Hmm? Compliments of the city? I'm sorry about what you're going through. You know, I know it must be tough. The divorce, your financial situation. Now you think I fucked up your face?
No, we're gonna work things out.
Work things out? What, are you retarded? Shorty took you for everything. What do you got left? A failed art gallery? A house you can't afford? She already moved in with that stockbroker from Marblehead, you dinkus. Come on, Jesus Christ, grow a pair.
Is it blowing steam off?
Poor deluded fuck. You know what, Tay, listen to me. You gotta treat divorce like death, all right? And there are certain stages of grief. First stage, denial, which you're firmly stuck in. Second stage, unfortunately, is anger. And you'll recognize it because it makes you want to do things like break your friend's face, shoot out some kneecaps, or occasionally slit a throat from ear to ear. Analogy aside, is there anything I'm saying to you that doesn't make sense? All right? Because you're not the only one accountable to somebody around here, all right? You know what it's like dealing with my father. You saw what he did to Tommy G. And he only owed $500. History or not, he's going to want his fucking money. And if he doesn't get it, I get it! Get it?
I gave you a ring. I gave you an opponent. And I gave you a crown.
This isn't fighting. Come on. I knocked out Charlie Shack in 4 rounds. That was fighting. I stood toe-to-toe with 2 heavyweight champions, all right? I was Jolton Jack Parker, Brooklyn's bare-fisted brawler.
The ravaging right hook from Red Hook.
That's right. And what am I now? I'm a bum. I'm a clown, a joke.
And you put me here.
No, you put you here. I told you not to get mixed up with those guys, but you wanted the extra cash, and now you're paying for it. And as far as this wrestling gig goes, that's the best that I could do for you, buddy. And now you got nothing. So pack up your stuff and cash your last paycheck and then take the bus home, because I sure ain't driving you back.
Go. Go, I don't need you. Fucking go. Take that fucking mask.
Good luck with Jeffries.
Fuck Jeffries. Jeffries!
Don't you love me? Huh? Go ahead. I dare you to say you don't love me. You see, honey, you gotta stop yourself from saying it. So why aren't we asleep together upstairs?
We've gone through it 1,000 times.
I know, honey, but let's go through it again.
No, I can't. I won't. I am exhausted. I haven't slept for 4 weeks.
Sure, neither have I. I mean, that's because we should be sleeping together in the same bed.
Oh, Mike, please go. I have got to get some rest.
Okay, fine. But first, I want to see my kids.
Oh, Mike, please.
No. They're my kids, okay? I got it right. I want to see him. His name is Mike Jr. My name is Mary Catherine, after my mother. They're mine, okay? I want to see them.
Mike, the whole neighborhood can hear you.
I don't care. I want to see my kids.
Stop, no.
Open the door,
honey,
Sheila.
I'm gonna call the cops.
Open the door. I don't care. Just open the door,
no,
Sheila.
I mean, I tried the blade, but I mostly falled. I do good falling. You know, you gotta have the right kind of balance and, well.
No. Yeah, well, it takes practice.
Well, I figured that, but, I get a little impatient sometimes with things, so it was.
Oh, right.
What?
Nothing.
What is it?
Nothing. I just said, oh, right.
Yeah, but you were, you know, you were about to say something.
It just. I'm not gonna say it.
Oh, come on. You already have, just about. You're a real killer overseas, weren't you, Carrick?
Well, that was Vietnamese and Japanese.
A real live killer. I'm a killer. Your father was a killer, too. We're all killers.
Get down on the floor now!
How about I kill you with my bare hands? Huh?
Sorry, I'm late.
Just getting worried.
I tried your cell phone.
Oh, jeez. Forgot to turn it on.
Did you order?
No, I waited. Gotta go?
No, I got a couple minutes.
Why'd you bother to come if you gotta go?
Because I didn't want you sitting all night waiting, alone.
So go.
No, I got time for coffee. Miss?
She been crying?
There you go, baby. Nice little girl.
Linda. Listen. If I ever see you with that prick, I'm gonna kill him. Not you, him. You hear me? You hear me, Linda? I own you, bitch. Remember that.
Well, what can I do for you?
Well, you're 3 weeks late. And Teddy is getting a little anxious about his money.
I know. I'm very sorry about that. Please tell Teddy that I'm doing everything I can and that he'll hear from me very soon.
Yeah, listen. He's through playing games, okay? He wants his fucking money.
Yeah, Chloe, that's it. You know why they got the dot on their forehead?
So I could say, get the fuck out of here! What are you, stupid? Don't fuck this up! This deal is gonna get me out of this basement and back upstairs where I belong, all right? Now get the fuck out of here!
Oh! Indians, like in Native American Indians.